Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to install Windows 7 in the VMware Workstation player. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to install Windows 7 in a VMware Workstation player, you can follow this guide. And you're going to need two things. You're going to need VMware Workstation player installed on your computer, and you'll need virtualization enabled, and then you'll also need the Windows 7 ISO file. Now, I have separate guides on this channel showing you how to do all of that, and I'm going to link them all in the description of this video so you can go ahead and get them from there. But once you have all of that, you can go ahead and launch VMware on your computer. Then once it's open, you can click on create a new virtual machine. Next, you can make sure that the installer disk image file is selected. Then you can click on browse. Then you need to navigate to where you have the Windows 7 ISO file saved. I have it saved on my desktop, so I'm going to select it, then click on open. It's going to detect that it's Windows 7 64-bit. And by the way, if you follow the guide that I link in the video's description, you can also get the 32-bit version of Windows 7. But once you've selected the ISO file, you can click on next. You can leave this first field blank, then you can choose your version of Windows that you want to install. For this example, I'll just install Windows 7 Pro. Then you can give the user a username, and you can also create a password, which is optional. Then you can click on next. You're going to get this prompt. You can just click on yes to continue. You can give the virtual machine a name. I'm just going to leave it on Windows 7 64-bit. And then you can also change the install location if you want by clicking on browse. I'm just going to leave it on the default and then click on next. And then next, it's going to create a virtual hard disk for this virtual machine. I'm just going to leave the defaults selected on both of these and then click on next. And then lastly, you can click on customize hardware if you want to give the machine more memory and more processors. I think for this video, I'm just going to change the RAM to 4 gigs, and the processors I'll change to 2, and the rest of these I'll just leave on the default. Then click on close. And then you can leave this box checked to power the virtual machine on after creating it. Then you can just click on finish. And it's then going to start creating that virtual machine. So the virtual machine should start up and then boot from the Windows 7 ISO file. And you should see a screen similar to this that says Windows is loading files. After a little while, you'll see this screen that says starting Windows. And then the Windows 7 installation screen is about to pop up. Next, you should see this screen that says installing Windows, and then you can just leave this process to complete. And then once the installation process is finished, you're going to get to your desktop. And if you're connected to a network, you should also see this screen. I'm just going to click on work network and then click on close. And then you'll have Windows 7 running inside of a virtual machine. So that's how you can install Windows 7 in VMware Workstation Player. And I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video, and I'll talk to you guys soon.